Mr. Sharma, Mr. Sharma, stop, stop. Ah, you are growing old, old man.
Look at yourself. This jogging is not going to affect on your grey hair either.
Come, let's sit.
Come on.
Let's do Anulom Vilom.
Oh, you mean Anulom Vilom?
Yeah, it's one of the same thing.
Today, I am not doing any Vilom. I have to get ready and rush to Election Commission office to lodge a complaint in grievance cell.
Oh, Mr. Sharma,
you seem to be very outdated. Why to go anywhere? Come, come to my place, we'll have a cup of tea. I'll show you how to file a complaint online. Okay, let's go.
Okay. Mr. Verma, the tea is very refreshing, but you should add some sugar in it.
Mr. Sharma, you already have a high sugar level. So stop relishing tea and look here. Election Commission has developed an online public grievance redressal system called PGRS.
Is it possible to register complaint on computer or laptop?
Not only through laptops or computers, you can do so on a smartphone or on a tablet PC as well. It's very simple. Just log on to Election Commission's website www.eci.nic.in and click on the Citizen Corner link on the home screen to register your complaint.
You will need to first register yourself. I hope you have your mobile with you, as we need to register and verify your mobile number.
Yes, I have mobile with me.
Oh, that's great. So let's get started.
Since you are a first time user, you need to register your mobile number and email ID to create an account. On the PGRS portal, register yourself as a new user by entering in your mobile number and email address. Type in the CAPTCHA code shown on the screen and click on register. You will receive a mobile verification code on your mobile.
Oh, so quick. I received SMS from Election Commission of India. Mr. Verma, the number is 1234.
That's great. We need to fill in the mobile verification code here in order to verify the mobile number. On clicking verify, you are directed to your profile page wherein you need to fill in your details such as name, age, gender, postal address, city, district, state, and choose a password for your account. Your mobile number itself is your user ID. Now press the submit button.
What do I do with my account?
On the complaint tab, go to register new complaint option and fill out necessary details related to state and district concerned with your complaint along with assembly constituency. Choose a category whether the complaint is being registered in election period or non-election period.
Mr. Verma, I have been waiting to lodge this complaint for a long time. My complaint is for non-election period.
Okay, let us select this option. Choose the subject related to your complaint from the drop-down list. You can choose from amongst the following: epic and electoral roll, political parties, website, feedback and suggestions, or any other.
Mr. Verma, thankfully, now I can get my incorrect entry corrected in the electoral roll. Please select epic and electoral roll option.
Now we need to put in the complaint briefly, describing the problem being faced by you. Press the proceed button to submit it. You will be taken to a page where you can view your registered complaint.
Mr. Verma, all this is fine, but I wonder how soon action will be taken.
As you can see, a complaint redressal time is maximum of 14 days as mentioned here. But before that, you must submit the complaint after checking the declaration statement.
Okay, how do I get confirmation on complaint registered?
Once you submit the complaint, it is registered and marked to the concerned officer. You may note down the complaint ID for future references as shown on the screen. Also for confirmation, complaint details are sent to you via SMS on your registered mobile number. Additionally, if you wish to upload any related document in JPEG format, you can do so at this stage.
Oh, that's correct. Just now I received SMS about my complaint ID and resolution time.
Mr. Sharma, I know, you have a habit of complaining a lot. So, is there any other grievance for which you need to use the PGRS portal again?
Mr. Verma, I have so many complaints, but maybe some other day.
Let me also tell you, at any point of time,
You can check the status of your complaint by clicking My Complaints option. That gives you a list of all the complaints made along with their status and details.
Mr. Verma, do you think that some action will be taken on my online complaint? I don't know whether some official have seen complaint or not.
Don't worry, Mr. Sharma. As soon as a complaint is registered, an SMS also goes to the concerned officer. In this case, the electoral registration officer. The SMS informs that a complaint is registered with respect to his or her jurisdiction. The officer is also notified of the time limit for the disposal of the complaint. If the officer is not able to access his or her web page immediately, the SMS is forwarded to some other subordinate officer who can immediately take action.
Oh, I see, Mr. Verma. What will happen if my complaint is not disposed of by concerned officer in redressal time period?
If the concerned officer does not dispose of the complaint in given time, then the same is escalated to the district election officer. And if the DEO is unable to take any action, then the complaint is further escalated to the chief electoral officer of the state.
Wow, I did not know that online procedure is so simple and hassle-free. Thanks to the Election Commission for providing PGRS.
Now you can help your other friends also. So, Mr. Sharma, next time, are we having some more friends for tea?
Sure.